Dear student, today we will find out Wien displacement law by Planck radiation formula. In this video, we will find out the Wien displacement law by Planck radiation formula. As we know that what is the Wien's law, that lambda and T is always equal to a constant equal to B, which has a numerical value term in 2.89 into meter into Kelvin 10^-3. By Planck radiation formula we will find out this law, which was very famous in starting of 19th century. Okay, as we know that Planck radiation formula, U lambda d lambda equal to 8 pi hc upon lambda 5 d lambda over exponential hc upon lambda kt minus 1. Equation number first. As we know that in black body radiations, for every value of wavelength there is a certain amount of energy is radiated, but as we see in graph, at a particular point for this value of lambda, we say that lambda m, for this value of lambda m, this temperature, on this temperature, this black body radiate a maximum energy amount. So we know that here is a curve, then at this point P, if we draw a tangent at point P, then the slope of this tangent equal to 0, then we can say that at point P, d of du lambda upon d lambda equal to 0. Now we will differentiate of equation first with respect to lambda. Now by differentiate with respect to lambda, we have eight pi hc is a constant. Differential of lambda raised to the power 5 equal to minus 5 upon lambda raised to the power 6 into 1 upon exponential sc upon lambda kt minus 1. Now we will differentiate the second term, which is 1 upon exponential lambda. Now by U and V method, we will have first term lambda raised to the power 1 upon 5 is constant, so we will put at lambda raised to the power 5 is a constant. And now we will differentiate this term, we will have minus 1 upon exponential hc upon lambda kt minus 1 whole square into, now the differential of exponential hc upon lambda kt minus 1. Now we will have differentiate this term, we will get exponential hc upon lambda kt into minus hc upon lambda square kt into d lambda.
this is bracket close. Now we can see that the cost and term, which are the same in both term, we will take outside of this bracket. 8 pi fc upon lambda raised to the power 6, and here lambda raised to the power 5 into 1 upon lambda square lambda to the power 7. Then we will take out lambda raised to the power 6. In the bracket we will have minus 5, and another term is exponential hc upon lambda kt minus 1 is also constant. Exponential hc lambda kt minus 1 is also constant term. Here 1, in this term minus minus plus lambda raised to the power 6 has been taken outside of this bracket. Here we have hc over lambda kt, hc over lambda kt into exponential hc over lambda kt upon exponential hc over lambda kt minus 1. Here we replace again like old video hc over lambda kt by a term x. We will have minus 5 plus x into exponential x upon exponential x minus 1 put is equal to 0, because at the point P we know that the tangent has angle 0 at point P because it changes its curvature. Now solve this equation, we will have 5 equal to x into exponential x over exponential x minus 1. Now we multiply exponential x minus 1, 5 into exponential x minus 5 equal to x into exponential x. Now we will take 5 equal to here, and exponential term here we will have 5 exponential x minus x into exponential x equal to 5. For further solve this equation, we will have we take a common exponential x into 5 minus x equal to 5. Hence we have exponential x equal to 5 upon 5 minus x. This is a algebraic equations. As we find out the root of these equations, we will find the value of x. We can solve this equation by two methods. We put first y equal to exponential x, and another y equal to 5 upon 5 minus x. By graph method we can solve this equation. If we plot a curve of these two equations, equation first and second, we have here an intersection point where the value of x will be shown. By solving this equation algebraic, we will find out the value of x equal to 4.596. This is the solution of equation. As we know that what was the x, we consider x here x equal to hc over lambda kt. Now we put x, the value hc over lambda kt equal to 4.96. Here we see that hc, k, all are these constants, so we put in same term as C over K, we divide by into 4.69. lambda and T we take at here right side. So now we will have lambda T equal to SC over K into 4.96. After putting this value, H is Planck constant, C is the speed of light in vacuum, K is the Boltzmann constant. After we solve this numerical value, we will have this value equal to 2.89 into 10 raised to the power minus 3. As we can say, the dimension of this constant is equal to, on the left hand side, lambda T, lambda in meter and T in Kelvin. The unit of this constant will equal to be meter into Kelvin. This constant term can be replaced by another symbol B. Here B is a Wien constant, and value of this B equal to 2.89 10 raised to the power minus 3 meter into Kelvin. This is the Wien displacement law. We saw that lambda inversely proportional to 1 upon T. We saw that as we increase the temperature of black body, then we will a particular wavelength where maximum energy is radiated is always going to smaller and smaller. Like that, here we have that in this curve, suppose that we have temperature equal to 1000 Kelvin, 1200 Kelvin, 1500 Kelvins. As we can see that as we increase the temperature, energy, the radiate energy amount is also increases, but at a point where maximum energy is radiated is always shifting to lower value. We can say that lambda is increasing this side, this point intersected here, the peak of this point intersected here, and peak of this point intersected here. So we can say that the value of lambda m decreases as the temperature increases. This is the Wien displacement law. According to this, as we increases the temperature of black body, the wavelength at a point where maximum energy radiated always displaced to lower value. Okay, in next video we will find out Stefan law by help of Planck radiation formula. Okay, thank you.